Alright, welcome to another inking session. Today I'm just, it's kind of a quick one, just doing something out of my sketchbook, just doing a Worf portrait from Star Trek Next Generation. Just been kind of on a Star Trek kick lately, but just trying to see if I could get these likenesses, and been pretty happy with the way it turned out. Anyway, just want to get to start inking on it, and as always, start with the face. All the characters have just been so great and complex in the within the show. Makes me want to just go back and watch them all, really. Michael Dorn, just brilliantly cast in this. I mean, he just really knocked this stuff out of the park. So much depth as an actor. To me, really just nailed the role. There's so many things that happened to the character, you know, in terms of character arc and whatnot, but man, he just really took it to another level. Because he can just do that deadpan comedy and just great. Everything about it, really, just unbelievable. In terms of series regulars, I don't know who had it worse, Data or Brent Spiner or Michael Dorn. Man, he probably had it the worst. To where Data's was just makeup up of the skin, maybe some contact eyes, and that's about it. That's a lot of prosthetics. It's only do you realize it when you're thinking about drawing it or something, you know. They really developed him over the seasons, you know. I mean, just growing his hair out alone just made him look like 100 times more badass, you know. Seemed like a no brainer, but just trying to think of their choices back then, but I was thinking maybe, you know, Starfleet had some type of regulation where you couldn't have it long. is probably the best Star Trek uniform design out of all of them. Although I like the jumpsuit from like Deep Space Nine with the grays, which kind of represents more wartime or something, but this is like the perfect design. A thicker cloth instead of the jumpsuit look and everything, man. It's just, ugh. I think I'm just gonna go full on black, but I might try to do some feathering here on the collarbone structure, but I don't think it's really gonna work because it's all supposed to be a dark cloth, but it's a good exercise. Paper almost gives it a dry brush look, which I kind of dig. Yeah, sadly I'm going to go full on black here, maybe just to the edge or something. Come in with some copic markers to make that the whole skin tone darker and everything, so so far. So good. Right, it's all right. Like it's solid black. Just gonna go with that. Now, for this. I'm gonna. For for the little sash, I gotta do. I'm going to do a pin. 3. There it is. Oh yeah, maybe I should do. We'll do the insignia. Now, cause this is so intricate here. the way this is turning out. I'm going to do a couple more characters from Star Trek as well. So if you have a request, let me know. Off the top of my head, I'm thinking Garak right now. That's a brilliant character. Quark. God, there's a lot of them. Yeah, pretty tough. I'm digging it. I'll try a little bit, erasing these pencil marks. Add some copic markers here in a minute. Oh shoot! I wanted to do that. Do that little brush. Build out that chest a little bit. Now I think I got too much ink on here. Dang. Yep. Too much ink. Just gonna try to do the number 3. Alright, moving on to the copic markers. Place that under here so it doesn't bleed through. Start with a C1 for the face. Hit that pretty hard for a base. Maybe leave the crest of the head. But his skin is going to be pretty dark, so. Let's come in here. Coming into C5 for what looks like, you know, the cloth part of the sash. Differentiate it a little bit, and I'm going to come in here with some highlights as well to really make it pop. Sell the chrome-ness. C5 to kind of give it more of a shadow, and you come back with the C3 to kind of blend it in better. C5 on the hair as well. I think I'm going to do a C1 for the yellowness. And then the C3 can do the shadows. I think it's going to work pretty well. Oh yeah. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Yeah, and they come in here with the C3. Just make some. think that will do it. For this episode, thanks for watching. And like I said, if you're a Star Trek fan, let me know what character you'd like to see, because I'm gonna do a couple more of these. Like I said, I'm real happy with the way this one turned out. Oh, highlight is right there. Boom. Highlight the collar there as well. All right. Well, thanks again for watching.